Thwarting vicious plot of Pakistan's inter-services intelligence, the Indian security forces recently arrested some dreaded pro-Khalistan extremists from Punjab. It includes a British national identified as Jagtar Singh Johal, alias Jaggi, who was arrested on November 4. Apart from target killings, these extremists are using the cyberspace to incite youth in Punjab. Jaggi was in touch with Khalistan Liberation Force members, including its chief, Harminder Singh. His name has emerged multiple times during interrogation of members of recently busted modules hired by Sikh extremist groups in Punjab. The interrogations have also revealed that there are links of foreign-based radical extremist entities that are trying to revive Sikh militancy in India.
One is that ISI link is well established. Two, the nexus between gangsters in providing the weapons is well established. Three, you know, exploitation of our innocent youth by radicalizing them. Unanu jo bahar baithe hain, jo local hai gaye, unanu, you know, to misguide. So that is also, you know, well established.
Jagtar Singh has also been associated with Guru Sharanbir Singh of the UK and Harmit, based in Pakistan, for promoting terror activities. He and Guru Sharanbir Singh have discussed ways to revive militancy in Punjab. Another Khalistan Liberation Front member, Taljeet Singh, who was in touch with Jaggi while living in Glasgow, Scotland, is now in jail for funding and sourcing of weapons.
Well, the ISI is always looking after any opportunity, whether it's Khalistani or anything. Anything to disturb peace in India is ISI's objective. So whether they are Khalistanis or just gangster type who have been involved, time will tell. Lekin certainly, it is the background is ISI.
And the consistent efforts of Pakistan have been and will continue to trying to ensure that there is somehow or the other there's some trouble in Punjab, there's some instability in Punjab, and not only in Punjab for that matter, in other parts of the country.
In UK, pro-Khalistan activists are running propaganda on social media that Jaggi was tortured by the police. This malicious campaign is being spread to catch the attention of British and Canadian parliamentarians and to put pressure on India to release him. Officers of the Punjab police who are involved with this case and their family members have received death threats. As videos of his court appearances show, he looks healthy and has no torture marks. His medical reports also show that there has been no torture. Punjab police has also been in touch with the British High Commission and have been updating them on the case. On November 15, two consular officers of the British High Commission, Margaret Patridge and Amit Kotesha, met him. They were satisfied that all legal rights were being provided to Jaggi. The British government is on the same page as India that Jaggi is involved with terror activities and that the law should take its course.